Two videos in a row. I'm on a roll now. Trying to keep quiet. Trying to keep a little bit quiet because the neighbors. Yeah, I filmed the video before this. Okay. Okay. Currently it's like 22nd of August. I'm probably wrong with that. I'll check later. Okay, so I'm reacting to the latest Zach Campbell video. That's what right here, for obvious reasons. And without further ado, getting right into this reaction. Actually, I don't know how many reaction videos I've done now. But so many reaction videos in a row, I might as well just rebrand and turn into a reaction channel. Okay.
Times I would like to have a Skype call with you.
Me whenever I get a video call and it's like a very formal one. Okay.
Megan, but how are you? I wanted to talk to you about your success, but here we are, talking about this. I think your story actually speaks volumes for just black women in general about how you're almost ignored and how we treat black women, how society view and treat black women, especially when their voice comes into play, when something serious comes into play. If you're just not joining the Skype call, you don't know what I'm talking about. Well, Megan and Tori's situation a couple of weeks ago, where everybody was kind of oblivious to what happened to Megan. Megan at the time was shot, and we didn't know who, how, why, and what was going on. Megan, you came out last night and said, well, you know...
Okay, let me stop right there. Yeah, we all had a thing. I'm not going to say all of us, some of us had a hunch that it was Tory Lanez that shot her. And that's why she's keeping quiet. Now, do not quote me on that, because all the stuff I'm saying is just opinion, it's not fact. So do not quote me on any of it.
So what's Tory? I've been trying to protect him, but here we are. You know what, Tory, you're dragging it, it's becoming a chop. And I instantly thought, like, wow, we all knew this though, Megan. We all knew. Pretty much kind of figured out after you did process of elimination. But even then, you still tried to protect him, and that says a lot. So then I got to thinking, this is a common thing, I feel like, when it comes to black women in the industry and just in general in real life. I feel like when black women go through struggles or go through something and they try to speak up, one, why are you trying to speak up? It's invalid. You have a lot of questions. You probably overreacted. And I'm like, why is that a thing? Only for black women, in my opinion. I guess you can say women. You can say women. But in my mind, if this was Kylie Jenner that got shot, let's talk about it. I'm just being real. I'm pulling cards. Can we have an honest conversation here? Let's dial it back to even my girl Keke Palmer. Keke Palmer and Trey Songz. Keke talked about 2 years ago, I remember watching the interview. Keke Palmer came out and talked about an encounter she had with Trey Songz years ago. And people was just like, what Keke Palmer got to talk about without Trey Songz? And I remember this is when Trey Songz was in his limelight. People were defending Trey Songz. Like, to the point where Trey Songz really didn't have to come out and speak about anything or really have to say much because, well, people had his best interest already. Why would she speak up? Why would she talk like this? And I'm like, why would she try to tear down another black man? I don't understand why did people think that Keke had any malicious intent to take down Trey Songz. What is Keke gonna do to Trey Songz? What is, like, I'm trying to figure out what was the motive? She wanted to be the new king of R&B? Like, what was the motive to make it seem like she was either hating or trying to be malice or just anything that was
what's
not the
thing
true?
Donald made midway through
the
video?
Why did we accept that truth? Maybe in your real life,
yikes,
where maybe your sister, your mother, your auntie came to you and said something happened, and you almost like, oh, well, let me, you know, do some research about it. Let me da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da. Instead of just taking the word for it and, you know,
it's just hate people. It's not wearing out. Okay.
For some reason with black women, I don't know why.
Just have to make
like
that very clear.
Try to make it seem like it's something else when it may be just what it is, and I don't know why we can't accept that. I applaud you, and I also want to be like, damn for you at the same time, because when the police arrived on the scene, you still defended Tory by not saying that there's a firearm in the car and that Tory was trying to, you know, shoot you. You could have said, you know what, that man press charges, the whole shebang, which in my mind you should have, but that's neither here or there. But you protected this black man.
I'm just getting some notifications
from
this video.
Even in this, in the moment of feeling attacked by this black man, because you knew that we were in the climate and always been in the climate of police brutality, and you see a car full of with a gun. Oh, girl. Somebody's getting shot, somebody going to jail, it was helicopters above. It could have been so many different scenarios that were more messed up than the others because they're black and it was a couple of black people and it was drama and arguing with black people and a gun. Oh girl, it could have went so south. But yet, Megan, you saved him. You made sure that, no, we can go a different way. To the point where you gave him enough wiggle room to where he could go to his public.
Oh, here we go, the ads. The thorn in my side.
Oh, it's a chilled coffee from Starbucks. Now that's chilled as in cold. Not cold because you left it in your mug to go.
Pick up something to really make the story kind of die down. Or maybe not what it was, or you cut your foot on the rug. But then I want to take it back to us, and I want to take it back to how we don't listen to black women. I'm still on that. I feel like black women have gone through, even with not even just traumatic situations, just even domestic violence situations. For some reason, we do not listen. And it's not all of us, don't get us wrong, it's not everybody. Or if they try to put power behind it, it's either an angry black woman. Oh yeah, so talk about it. If you have too much passion behind how you feel, or you are correct, or you have pointed to prove someone wrong, now you're an angry black woman. Why is that a case? I've never heard angry white woman before, except for Karen. But that's another situation. I never heard when a white woman speaks up.
It was mysterious, but I just lost it when he mentioned Karens. yeah, on a serious note, what happened to Megan was bad.
Passion and have proof that they're angry white women. But I've heard if a black woman speaks up, especially against a black man, and that black man will continue to figure out how to tear down that black woman. I'm just like, what sense does that make? How are we supposed to evolve as people? Especially because of where I come from. You know, my girls in Detroit, there's a lot of issues of domestic violence. There's a lot of issues of being mistreated, and their voices get muted. Nobody's listening to them. Nobody's listening to Miss Girl up the street. Nobody's listening to Miss Girl down the way. Because they think that they don't have a voice. You need this man. You need this man to take care of you and your kids. Oh, don't let you be on government support. Oh, girl, your voice. Because you have to defend your trauma. How do you think that feels when you have to defend your trauma, when you have to say, this really did happen to me? But think of it on a bigger scale than just your friends not believing you, or your family not believing you. The whole world is looking at you in a microscopic level. Something traumatic happens to you, and because the details are vague, because you choose them to be, you're not telling the whole truth. You're doing this for clout. You're doing this for attention. I've seen people under her tweets and comments try to find every other reason that wasn't the truth of why, of what happened. And Megan had to defend her trauma. Say, this really did happen to me. I have to relive it because I have to keep explaining it. Man, mind you, this girl's had a number one record. Think about how this is, even down to me making videos. I made a Skype call about Cardi B winning, and now I'm making a Skype call about you, Megan. It's about a traumatizing event in your life that you have to keep defending. And unfortunately, that's the headline today. And it's almost like that the higher you go up the ladder, the scarier it gets. You have to realize, Megan Thee Stallion, you see what she wants you to see. I mean, I feel like what you see through the peephole of her life, through Instagram, YouTube, and music videos is only maybe 10% of what she really goes through in real life. I guess I could talk about Tory, because I wasn't going to at first. I was going to leave him out of this guy call completely. But what argument got you so upset to the point where you need to draw a gun? I don't know.
Yeah, that's a good question. That's what I want to know. It's not about, not about who set up the gun. Why? Why? I don't know why. I actually liked Drillin before this, because I had heard the song that he was on with Kehlani. I like that song. You know that song, Can I? Yeah, that song's good. Yeah. But that's not the point. The point is he shot Megan. Megan confirmed it in Instagram Live. I didn't see the Instagram Live, but I know people who did. And I'm speaking just telling people what I say. I knew it, I guess. I had a hunch, and I guess my hunch was right. And Clem is right.
I push you to the limit to the point where you felt like you needed to pull out a gun and somebody that was walking away. Y'all both public figures. You knew it could go left. What if you killed her? Then what? I need to know what was the big deal. Because I don't understand. Now your career is over.
I'm with him. I don't know why.
You shot Megan Thee Stallion. No one would ever forget that. Oh, no, Tory Lanez, the one that shot Megan Thee Stallion. Yeah, your discography is over to me. I listened to it at first. I didn't like what you sung in the first place. I thought you sung with Out-of-Tune.
Shit. My thing died. Back in action, my laptop died. Now I've got the cable right here, and we're back in action.
You thought y'all was the same person, but now after this happened, and I'm now going through your discography, I'm like, so what are we missing? But now you've diminished all of that work that you have done. I think you should get charged.
I think so too.
I honestly feel like
I think you should get charged. Back to Canada you go. Yeah, because he's Canadian. Jail. Don't know how much time you get done, but the maximum for it. Oh, God. That sounds so harsh, don't I?
Be charged for what you've done. I think that that's the only fair part of this whole thing, you know? Justice. You need to go to jail. You need to be charged with assault. Or attempted murder, if you want to be really sick, but that's neither here nor there.
Assault with deadly weapon.
I think that you shouldn't be able to release
music.
Isn't
that the charge?
I don't think you should be able to release music. Girl, I don't want to go down the whole road. I think it's some shit should get stripped. That's neither here or there. He's not a part of the label anymore, so that's that. At this point, Tori, it's a chop for you. In my opinion.
It's a wrap.
All in all, Megan, I'm happy that you are safe. I'm happy that you came out about this. I'm happy that you talked about it. Because it's a lot. It's a lot. Like, on top of police brutality, on top of being a female in this industry, because that's a whole another topic, and now being shot by another black man in the industry, it's insane. And the fact that people didn't want to believe you or wanted to defend him or figure out where you're lying or why you would lie, it's absolutely insane to me. Like, it's just like, why is there even any doubt? If she's coming out saying, hey, this black man hurt me or this person hurt me, it don't have to be a black man. If a black woman's coming out and saying, hey, this person hurt me. That's just like my people, my black queer people. We come out and say something, oh, it's because you dressed like that. It's because you had this on. Me having a wig or lipstick on is make you that upset? Something's wrong here. Something's wrong here. You're my trans sisters. It goes all the way down for some reason. For some reason, the voices are not heard. We don't care. We think it's invalid. Or how some people think it's funny to record and laugh and run away. Even when I saw, like, memes of Megan Thee Stallion walking away and like limping and stuff, I was like, we're making fun of this now?
Who makes memes out of
this
stuff?
Is a meme to you? This is where I'm saying we need to evolve as people if we're going to do this. If we're going to come together,
no, don't speak to humor, but I don't, but I'm not that.
It starts with us. Megan,
not to
I love
that
you,
degree.
And thanks. I hope that you get the justice you deserve. And I hope that this does something for you. I hope that it breaks through something. And I hope that you don't go through anything like this again. Honestly, and I hope that you understand that we should have listened. Period. And that's just how I feel. That's how I feel. Now, you may feel a different way if you're joining this Skype call. You may feel like, I don't know. Let me know in the comments below. I want to know. Yeah, that's all I have to say. I love you. Can't wait to see what you come up with next.
Okay. Okay, I'm gonna be honest, this is not the first video I've seen about this, but I wanted to hear what he himself had to say, because I've watched a couple of his videos before and I've liked them. Okay, so I wanted to hear what he had to say about it. Okay, I don't have a clue what to say, really, because I've all the stuff I've had to say. Also, I wanted to say either he has said or I've said it during watching his reaction to his video about this situation. So, with that being said, I'll see you in the next video. Whenever the video may be, I don't have a clue when. Next video, maybe at this point, it's all up in the air for me. It could be next week, it could be the week after, a month's time, 6 months' time. It'll be at some point within this year, maybe towards the end of the year. Okay, so I'm off to edit, upload this video, and watch more videos, get more creative juices flowing, and to buy more clothes and alcohol. Bye.